Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to give you an idea about data science for beginners. Data science is all about using data to solve problems. The problem could be decision making, such as identifying which email is spam and which is not. So the core job of a data scientist is to understand the data, extract useful information out of it, and apply this in solving the problems. Let's start with data science process. Discovery, data preparation, model planning, model building, operation, communicate results. These are the steps in data science process. Let's see in detail. Discovery. It involves acquiring data from all the identified internal and external sources, which helps you to answer the business question. The data can be logs from web server, data gathered from social media, census data set, data streamed from online sources using APIs. Data preparation. In this step, data can have lots of inconsistencies, like missing value, blank columns, incorrect data format, which needs to be cleaned. You need to process, explore, and condition data before modeling. When you clean your data, the better are your predictions. Model planning. In this stage, you need to determine the method and technique to draw the relation between input variables. Planning for a model is performed by using different statistical formulas and visualization tools. SQL analysis services, R and SAS or ASSES, are some of the tools used for this purpose. Model building. In this step, the actual model building process starts here. Data scientist distributes data set for training and testing. Techniques like association, classification, clustering are applied to the training data set. The model, once prepared, is tested against the testing data set. Operationalize. In this stage, you deliver the final baselined model with report, code, and technical documents. Model is deployed into a real-time production environment after through testing. The last step is communicate result. In this stage, the key findings are communicated to all the stockholders. It will help you to decide if the result of the project are success or a failure based on the input from the model. Next, we are going through some of the data science jobs and its roles. Most prominent data scientist job titles are data scientist, data engineer, data analyst, statistician, data administrator, business analyst. Let's see in detail. Data scientist job role is, it is a professional who manages enormous amount of data to come up with compelling business visions by using tools, techniques, methodologies, algorithms, etc. They handle some of the languages like R, SAS, Python, SQL, Hive, MATLAB, Pig, Spark. Data engineer, his role is of working with large amount of data. He develops, construct, test and maintains architecture like large scale processing system and databases. They handle the languages like SQL, Hive, R, SAS, MATLAB, Python, Java, Ruby, C++ and Perl. Data analyst is responsible for mining vast amount of data. He or she will look for relationships, patterns, trend in data. Later, he or she will deliver compelling reporting and visualization for analyzing the data to take the most viable business decisions. They use the languages like R, Python, HTML, JS, C, C++, SQL. Statistician. He collects analysis, understand qualitative and quantitative data by using statistical theories and methods. The languages they use are SQL, R, MATLAB, Tableau, Python, Perl, Spark, and Hive. Data administrator, or we can call him as data admin, should ensure that the database is accessible to all relevant users. He also makes sure that it is performing correctly and is being kept safe from hacking. They use the languages like Ruby, SQL, Java, C#, Python. The next and the last job, data science job, is business analyst. This professional need to improve business processes. He or she as an intermediary between the business executive team and IT department. The languages they use are SQL, Tableau. This is the important topic in this video. Stages in data science project. Define the goal. In this first stage, you should think about what problem am I solving. Collect and manage data. You must think about the information do you need. And build the model. You have to find patterns in the data that leads to solution. Evaluate and critique model. Does the model solve my problem?
present result and documents. You should establish that I can solve the problem and how you are going to solve this problem. Deploy model. Deploy the model to solve the problem in the real world. Let's see in detail. The first stage and the first task in the data science project is define the model. Defining a measurable and quantifiable goal. And this goal should be specific and precise. In this stage, we are starting to define the precise goal of the project. And also, it should be measurable. The goal is then come up with candidate hypothesis. These hypotheses can then be turned into concrete questions or goals for a full-scale modeling project. And collect and manage data. This is the most important step and also most time-consuming step in this process. This is the stage where you conduct initial exploration and visualization of the data. You will also clean the data, repair data errors, and transform variables as needed. And in this stage, you may discover things in the data that raise issues more important than the one you originally planned to address. Build the model. Here, the most common data science modeling tasks are classification. Here, deciding if something belongs to one category or another. Scoring, here predicting or estimating a numeric value such as a price or probability. In this ranking task, learning to order items by preferences. Clustering task is grouping items into most similar groups. Finding relations. Here, finding correlations or potential causes of effect seen in the data. And the last data science modeling task is characterization. Here, it is a very general plotting and report generation from data. Evaluate and critique model. Once you have a model, you need to determine if it meets your goals. So, is it accurate enough for your needs? Or does it generalize well? You have to think all these. Does it perform better than the obvious guess? Better than whatever estimate you currently use? Do the result of the model make sense in the context of the problem domain? You should evaluate all these and critique model. Present results and document. Once you have a model that meets your success criteria, you will present your result to your project sponsor or other stockholders. You must also document the model for those in the organization who are responsible for using, running and maintaining the model once it has been deployed. We know that different audiences requires different kind of information. The last stage is deploy model. You make sure that the model can be updated as its environment changes. And in many situations, the model will initially be deployed in a small pilot program. The test might bring out issues that you didn't anticipate, and you may have to adjust the model accordingly.
Working with data from files. Here we will discuss some of the file formats that you find useful in data scientist field. As a data scientist, there are various ways of storing data, sharing data, as well as different sources to acquire and augment data. Several ways of gathering data for analysis are CSV file. This is the most common format for storing and sharing data set, and it is comma separated format or CSV file. This is the most useful and powerful method. Flat file. This offers a variety of methods to read file, that is tab separated or a fixed width format or a semicolon separated, etc. appropriately. Text file. This is another way of reading a text file as context managers. They are very effective in allocating and managing resources. Most widely used example of context managers is the with statement. This is in a single file reading data all at once. But in the case of reading data line by line, you have downloaded tweets data using Twitter API TweeP, and you have saved all the tweets in a text file, right? Let me show you how to get Twitter data using TweeP. That is reading this tweets JSON.txt file to extract useful information. SIP file. This is to extract .sip file from Python. You need to use a SIP file library. SIP file is also a context manager and will support the with statement. API JSON. We know that application programming interface. We can extract information from web page, but a better way of accessing information is through an API. We will use Python library wp-tools. Multiple text file. When a situation where your data is provided to you in the form of multiple text files, we will use a library glob, which makes opening files with similar path structures simple. download file from internet. If you have to download a file kept on a server, you will have to use a library request. From that you can download the file easily. Web page. It's a fancy way of extracting data from the web pages using code. Data that lives on the web pages is called HTML, Hypertext Markup Language. HTML code is just text. These tag and content within them can be extracted using a parser. For this, we will use a library, Beautiful Soup. And I think it's very beautiful, right? RDBMS, Relational Database Management System. Connecting to database and importing data into a data frame. Connecting to database and storing data from a data frame to database. That is, connecting to the database is in Python. We will connect to SQLite database using SQAlchemy, a database toolkit for Python. Then store the data frame in a database. Then you can read database table in the data frame. Working with relational databases. Relational database uses tables, which are called records. These records possess many columns with different names and data types. We can then establish connections among records by using primary key and foreign key to identify table schema relationships. RDBMS allows scalability based on the server distribution rather than Excel. Excel has a limited amount of rows and columns. It also allows users to establish defined relationships between tables. In relational database management system, we use SQL instructions to reproduce and analyze data separately. When we open up a connection, we also establish a cursor. A database cursor is a tool to traverse over database records. Using this cursor, we can create tables and execute SQL commands into the database disk. We can use the cursor to execute SQL query and also create table. If we insert rows with the same ID and date and time, it will return a duplicate error. This validation is useful to prevent unclean redundant data to enter the database. Exploring data. Exploratory data analysis is an approach to extract the information enfolded in the data and summarize the main characteristics of the data. It is considered to be a crucial step in any data science project. EDA is essential for a well-defined and structured data science project, and it should be performed before any statistical or machine learning modeling phase. It is an essential part of data exploration is data transformation. Some commonly used plots for EDA
are histogram. Histogram is used to check the distribution of a specific variable. Scatter plot is used to check the dependency between two variables. Map to show distribution of a variable on a regional or world map. Feature correlation plot or heat map. It is to understand the dependencies between multiple variables. Time series plot. It is to identify trend and seasonality in time-dependent data. Managing data. The best way to manage data and eventually get the insight needed to make data-driven decisions is to begin with a business question and acquire the data that is needed to answer that particular question. Managing your data is the first step towards handling the large volume of data, both structured and unstructured, that floods business daily. In fact, data management via leading data management platforms enables organizations and enterprises to use data analytics in beneficial ways, such as personalizing the customer experience, adding value to customer interactions, improving customer engagement, increasing customer loyalty, reaping and revenue associated with data-driven marketing, and identifying the root cause of marketing failure and business issues in real time.